Welcome to the home of 100 to 1 Faith. I'm Larry Gent, and this is the message for Grace Hartwood United Methodist Church on this, the 30th day of August. It's a fifth Sunday, and I like to turn to music as the message in those weeks. Our topic this morning is All American Hymns.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
I'd have to confess the thing I miss most in this time of quarantine is having a good old hymn sing with God's people. Hymn singing is such an important part of our faith and worship that it might be surprising to learn that the church didn't always think it was such a great idea. In Europe, the congregation was not encouraged to sing. In fact, the Anglican Church did not approve hymn singing until 1820, although John and Charles Wesley were ordained Anglican clergy, they opened the door to congregational singing. In fact, they published 56 hymn collections in 53 years. The Wesleys and their friend George Whitfield brought hymn singing to the American frontier. Their Methodists and Baptists made it a mainstay, and that new style of worship spread like wildfire. But those early hymn books were published without music. Until the 1830s, people only had the text of the hymns. So in those days, lining out was a common way to add the melody. The leader would sing a line, and the people would reply. This helped spread hymns in places where books were scarce and many folks couldn't read or write. Lining out is still used in some churches to this day. Here's a regular Baptist congregation in Kentucky singing a hymn style that dates back at least to the 1700s.
My heart is so to take me in.
That call and response style traces its roots back to the cantor leading the singing of the Jewish congregation way back in Old Testament days. But there was another style of call and response in America that dates back just as far. African music uses call and response to this day, as her people have for thousands of years. Here's Roll Jordan Roll, a call and response spiritual. You might have heard this version of the song in the movie 12 Years a Slave.
Went down to the River Jordan, where John baptized three. When I walked the devil in hell, says Johnny baptized me. I say, roll, Jordan, roll, roll, Jordan, roll. My soul will rise in heaven, Lord, for the year old Jordan, roll. Well, some say John was a Baptist. Some say John was a Jew. But I say John was a preacher, cause my Bible says so too. I say, roll, Jordan, roll. Roll, Jordan, roll. My soul arise in heaven, Lord, for the year when Jordan roll. Hallelujah. Roll, Jordan, roll. Roll, Jordan, roll. My soul arise in heaven, Lord, for the year when Jordan roll. Hallelujah.
Roll, Jordan, roll. Roll, Jordan, roll. My soul arise in heaven, Lord, for the year when Jordan roll.
Everybody say, roll, Jordan, roll.
in heaven, Lord, for the year when Jordan rolled. Roll, Jordan, roll. Roll, Jordan, roll. My soul arise in heaven, Lord, for the year when Jordan rolled. Roll, Jordan, roll. Roll, Jordan, roll. My soul arise in heaven, Lord, for the year when Jordan rolled.
In America, especially in the South, those two streams of European call and response and African call and response mingled to form what we know as gospel singing. But there was a third stream here, often overlooked but just as powerful. Here, Purafe and the Eulalie singers give us a taste of ancient Tuscarora call and response singing. I think you'll hear a wild, lonesome quality that adds its Native American voice to the river that we call gospel music. That sound comes to us from Carolina, but this same call and response style was practiced by the indigenous people all over America. The White Mountain Apaches have a long tradition of hymn singing, both ancient and modern. Here is a timeless prayer song in a Southwestern style, but the same wild, haunting voice.
Oh,
course, gospel music evolved with time. Around the Civil War era, hymnals began including musical notation with the text. But there was still a shortage of church musicians who could read the notes. Enterprising Americans revived an ancient system of shape note singing. A different shape was assigned to each note of the scale. That meant the lead singer didn't have to know where middle C was on the piano. All she had to do was know the notes of the scale. Traveling music teachers went from town to town, teaching people how to read and sing this shape note system. Soon, the Cokesbury and the Baptist hymnals were both available in shape note versions. This movement started in New England, but soon spread to the South, where there are shape note singing schools in operation to this very day. The best known hymnal for these schools was called the Sacred Harp, and Sacred Harp singers still gather from all over America to attend singing conventions. The Methodist hymnal included this hymn from the Sacred Harp until 1968, His Voice as the Sound of a Dulcimer Sweet. The tune is called Samantha, and I think they need to bring it back. Here is John McCutcheon playing it on his sweet dulcimer, while shape note singers add the vocals. See if you hear that wild, lonesome sound still present on this one.
Thank you.
After the Civil War, the Second Great Awakening swept across America with camp meetings and revivals and gospel music. Fanny Crosby wrote 8,000 gospel songs, and no revival was complete without a few of them. Gospel quartets often headlined along with traveling preachers at these events. Here is the Emmanuel Quartet doing Blessed Assurance, one of Fanny Crosby's best-known songs.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God. Born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight. Visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending bring from above echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I and my Savior am happy and blessed. Watching and waiting, looking above, filled with his goodness, lost in his love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
By the 1920s, radio was taking gospel to a whole new audience. A family from the hills of Virginia changed country music and gospel forever when they stepped behind the microphone and began to sing. Here is our own Carter family singing Can the Circle Be Unbroken?
I was standing by the window on one cold and cloudy day, and I saw the hearse come rolling for to carry my mother away. Oh, can the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a bitter home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. Lord, I told thee, Undertaker, Undertaker, please drive slow. For this body you are hauling, Lord, I hate to see her go. Can the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a bitter home away. but I could not hide my sorrow when they laid her in the grave. Can the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a bitter home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. My mother, she was gone. All my brothers, sisters crying, what a home so sad and lone.
Can the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a bitter home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
The 20th century saw the rise of a new style of sacred music, and no one did it better than Thomas A. Dorsey. Widely known as the father of gospel music, he wrote over 1,000 songs and began publishing them at age 20. His career spanned most of the 20th century, but his best-known song might be "Precious Lord, Take My Hand." A fella named Elvis is going to sing it for us now.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am I'm weak and worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to light. Take my hand, precious Lord.
Precious Lord, lead me home.
By the 1950s, American music was getting electrified, and gospel music was no exception. Sister Rosetta Tharpe loved to sing old-time gospel songs while playing her newfangled electric guitar. Her musical stylings influenced everyone from future generations of gospel artists to the Rolling Stones. Many people say she's the godmother of rock and roll, but she's here this morning to remind you, Jesus is everywhere. As we entered the digital age, the power of radio was amplified with platforms like YouTube and social media streaming gospel music. Groups became superstars, filling mega churches and arenas with praise music. Everything about these shows was high tech, with big screens, laser shows, and digital music. But they still used that old-time call and response to reach out and grab people. One of the most popular groups of this era was Third Day, and one of their most popular songs was Soul on Fire.
So don't you know it? It goes like this.
Yeah, I'm running for your heart. I'm running for your heart. Till I am a
soul on fire.
I'm fired up now. I'm ready. You ready, Boston? Here we go now. Put your hands together. Front to the back. Up there in the mountain. Y'all stand up. Have a sound now. Hey.
I'm running for your heart, till I am a soul on fire. Lord, I'm longing for your ways, I'm waiting for the day when I am a soul on fire, till I am a soul on fire.
Hey. Are you ready, Boston?
till I am
so on fire.
Lord, I'm longing for you. When I am so on fire, till I am so on fire. Let this be our prayer tonight. Pray that we sing it in truth and in spirit. Lord, let me burn for you again.
Soon, gospel music became a major part of the music industry, but these days, everything that was old is becoming new. We're seeing a revival of traditional bluegrass gospel music being performed by young people who love those old songs. Now, Jamie Wilson wants us to know, "Ain't no grave gonna hold my body down." It's definitely a 21st century arrangement, but it has all the traditional elements in place. Listen again for the call and response parts, just like the earliest examples I played for you.
Drop it until you hear from me. Oh, go down yonder river.
Well, when it comes to gospel music, there's a whole lot more to tell and a whole lot more to sing about. But this story of American gospel music really can't be told without including some gospel songs about America. So here to wind up our musical message is a song set from the book of Revelation. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. May gospel music follow you everywhere you go this week, and may God's songs always fill your heart.